within our kind of team composition, there are, you know, two data science people, two history people, just because this is a, I think, a well-rounded project. It's, you know, it's the humanities and sciences together, which I think is really fun. Okay, we're taking art history because we have to know what's in this map. And then we're expanding into the computer science kind of realm to, in order to analyze what's in this map, as well as sort of cartography or geography, or even what a term we've sort of come up with that sort of exists. It's a bit shaky, but this thing called choreography. And we're combining all those things in order to kind of unpack the art history into something that we can distribute to other people. My majors are environmental science and medieval and Renaissance studies. So it's kind of the medieval and Renaissance side that applies here, and gives me that background that's kind of useful. Although I'm not a huge expert on Portugal because I kind of studied slightly different areas of Europe, but still relevant.
Our project is specifically on the Air Force came to us, and specifically Seymour Johnson here in North Carolina, with the problem that they just have too many jets that are on the ground due to unscheduled maintenance. We have a master's in ethics student, we have students in entrepreneurship, biology, kind of all over the place.
The really fun thing about like statistics is that it's kind of applicable in multiple different areas. So like I've been attending these, like the morning talks with the different projects, and it's so interesting to see how we're kind of, a lot of the different teams are working on completely different subject areas, but we're working with similar methods in statistics. And so kind of dabbling in different fields, but using the same methods, and also working with real data as opposed to data given in your classes has been really cool, and has been a really good experience for me this summer.
So. I'm really thankful to have learned so much about a topic that people would probably never put in the same category as data science, machine learning. You know, it's usually seen as two completely different practices. Art history, architecture, everything, like it's all incorporated in this specific project, which has made it very rewarding, I think.
It's a much wider kind of project or group of programs than you might imagine it to be. There are some that are focused on history, some that are focused purely on data, some that are focused on, you know, politics in your local area. Like there are so many different projects that you can focus on for so many different interest areas, whether you're interested in history or econ or biology or just plain computer science. So don't think you'll be spending all day, you know, typing up code. There are many, many more aspects to it than you might imagine. So that's definitely, you know, fun. It's available for pretty much anybody.